السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر، الله أكبر، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
الحمد لله، الحمد لله الذي خلق السماوات والأرض وجعل الظلمات والنور ثم الذين كفروا بربهم يعدلون. هو الذي خلقكم من طين ثم قضى أجلا وأجل مسمى عنده ثم أنتم تمترون. وهو الله في السماوات وفي الأرض يعلم سركم وجهركم ويعلم ما تكسبون. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده، وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا وسندنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله، هو الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله. قال الله عز وجل: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. قال الله عز وجل: إن الدين عند الله الإسلام. صدق الله مولانا العظيم. الشيخ great sheikh of 8th century. He lived during the time of Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, a great theologian, and also he was deep in spirituality. His name is mentioned Sheikh Shafiq Balkhi. Hundreds, thousands of students or the people benefited from him. He had a special student and his name was Hatim al-Asam. He stayed with him approximately 33 years under his supervision. A precious time he spent, long period of time, he acquired knowledge from Sheikh Shafiq Balkhi. One day, a teacher called his student and asked him, "Hatim, how long you stayed with me?" "Sir, I stayed approximately 33 years. 33 years, long period of time, a precious time of your life. What did you learn in 33 years? "Sir, I learned only 8 things." "You spent 33 years with me and you learned only 8 things? Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un." Apparently the teacher was showing his frustration that within 33 years he learned only 8 things. "Okay, tell me, what did you learn? Share with me." "Sir, the first thing that I have learned, And now this is my experience, and I've observed the people in this world, they love someone or something. They're not out of love. They love their parents or their children or a husband or a wife or their friends, or they love things. Maybe they love their car, they love their houses, they love their, at that time there were no cars, by the way. Transportation, just name it. Or they love anything else. You know, each and every single person, they love someone or something. They said, sir, when I observed this and I found their love goes only after a certain time or certain place. They love these things only for the people they love him up to when he takes his last breath. Then they carry him to the Kabristan, graveyard, and bury him. Then I checked who goes with him in his grave. I checked no one goes with his grave. They bury him, maybe they are sad, they return back, and life must go on. They live their life. When I found that no one goes with him in his grave, okay, they are loving, but I give priority to love my virtues. I start loving my good deeds. Going to be with me in this world, and my good deeds, my virtues will be in my grave. Then I'm going to be, leave me alone, and these my virtues and good deeds will be with me in the life of hereafter. I give priority to love my virtues, my deeds. The teacher was happy. He said, Subhanallah, you learned something good. Great. He appreciated him. Okay, something amazing. What's next? Sheikh, the next thing that I have learned, I have found the people, you know, they are hating each other. They have a jealousy. And because of their jealousy, because of their hatred, they become enemy to each other. And they try to race with one another. The person who has good house or maybe good business, and the second one will try to beat him up. He will think, I should have better than him, a good position. And because of this, all these things, they become jealous, and then they create hatred in their hearts. And when I recited this ayah, نَحْنُ قَسَمْنَا بَيْنَهُمْ مَعِيشَتَهُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَرَفَعْنَا بَعْضَهُ فَوْقَ بَعْضٍ دَرَجَاتٍ لِيَتَّخِذَ بَعْضُهُمْ بَعْضًا سُخْرِيَّةً. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, it is we who portion out between themselves, in between them, their livelihood in this world. So it is we who portion out. We divide, we make someone higher and someone lower. So after learning this, I don't carry animosity to anyone. That the hatred and the jealousy was in my heart, I took it out. I'm no more jealous to anyone. If I see that someone is blessed with, I make dua for him. May Allah bless you more. May Allah bless you more. I'm not jealous. Subhanallah. The Sheikh said, yes, this is very good. You are learning something good. Okay, what is next? Sheikh, I have learned that the people in this world, you know, people in this world, they seek their, you know, their honor through their positions. They seek honor through their wealth. Or maybe they are very proud of their language or their nationality or their color, their creed, their family. And they feel very proud of that, and they seek their honor. You know, they are honored. And when I found all these things doesn't have any weight. They do not live longer. And when I check this Quranic ayah, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ إِنَّا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ ذَكَرٍ وَأُنْثَى وَجَعَلْنَاكُمْ شُعُوبًا وَقَبَائِلَ لِتَعَارَفُوا إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ يَتْقَاكُمْ. O mankind, we created you from single male and female, and then we made you into different tribes and the clans, so that you may recognize one another. The most honored in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who is pious. The most honored. When I learned this ayah, inna akramakum inda Allah yatqakum. The most honor in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who is more pious. I tried my best. I tried my best to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not because of other things, but it's because of, and I tried my best to come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through my virtues. And I do not rely, I don't, like, you know, feel myself that I'm honored because of the other things. So, alhamdulillah. This is something excellent. What's next? Says, when I have recited this ayah, وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ وَنَهَا النَّفْسَ عَلِ الْهَوَى فَإِنَّ الْجَنَّةَ هِيَ الْمَأْوَى وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ. So who is feared of standing before his Lord, and he restrains himself from all kind of impure and evil desires, وَنَهَا النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى فَإِنَّ الْجَنَّةَ هِيَ الْمَأْوَى. Jannah will be his abode. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless him in Jannah. So when I've learned this ayah, I tried my best to stay away from all kind of impure and evil desires. If I would like to go to Jannah, I have to stay away. And after learning this ayah, that I'm trying my best every day to increase my level of taqwa. And for each and every single step that I take, I think first whether will me make me more closer to Allah, or will be take me away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Says, subhanallah, it's great. Okay, what is next? Then he said, Shaykh, I have learned one more thing, that I've observed the people, if they have something valuable, something precious, they will preserve it, they will save it. Just like that, if we have a gold or the silver or the money or something valuable, we're going to preserve it. We're going to keep it in the lockers. If we have a money, we're going to deposit in our banks. If something is valuable, we're going to keep it in our house, shelves, cupboards, whatever. Yeah, they're preserving it, they're saving it. So when I learned this ayah, مَا عِنْدَكُمْ يَنْفَدُ وَمَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ بَاقٍ. Whatever is with you is going to be destroyed. But whatever is with Allah will remain forever. It's just like that, we have experience. If someone is hit by natural disaster, maybe he has everything, but because of natural disaster, suddenly, you know, he loses everything. So, Hatim al-Assam, the student said, Sir, after learning this, مَا عِنْدَكُمْ يَنْفَدُ وَمَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ بَاقٍ, anything valuable comes in my hand, I spend in Allah's way. Because it will be forever. If I hold it, maybe it's not going to stay longer. And I have no guarantee. I'm not sure that how long this thing will be with me, and how much benefit can I take from this thing. But what is with Allah is permanent, is forever. Yes, subhanAllah, this is very important. What is next? Then he said, Shaykh, our Lord, the people are worried about their food, their sustenance, their risk, and they are restless. They always worried about what I'm going to do next year, next month, within 5 years. They make plans. They're worried about. They accumulate maximum. And finally, they don't know whether it's a haram or halal sources. They don't care. But they want to become rich. And they are worried about their sustenance. When I learned this ayah, وَمَا مِن دَابَّةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا عَلَى اللَّهِ رِزْقُهَا وَمَا مِن دَابَّةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا عَلَى اللَّهِ رِزْقُهَا. Whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created on this earth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took responsibility of his sustenance. Allah is a responsible. Wama min dabbatin, but it does not mean that just sit aside and become unproductive member of the society. Don't do anything and just say, okay, Allah will provide me. Yes, Allah ta'ala created everything for you. It does not mean don't work. Work. Adopt your professions. But at the same time, don't worry about too much worries. What will happen next? After doing your activities, after doing your job, leave it on Allah. Because ultimately, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who provides you sustenance, a risk. He is responsible. Then he said, after learning this, I was not worried about. Although I'm working, I'm carrying on my life as a normal life, I'm doing it. But I'm not worried about because Allah is the responsible. He says, Subhanallah, it's great. What else? He says, Shaykh, I've learned another thing. People are enemy to each other. They hate each other. They kill each other. As you have observed, killings is so frequent. You know, Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, the time will come, the one who is killing, he will not be able to know why he is killing. The one who killed, he will not be able to know why I am killed. You know, killing will be so frequent. And it's because of what? You know, they are enemy to each other. So when I've learned this ayah, إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌّ فَاتَّخِذُوهُ عَدُوًّا إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌّ فَاتَّخِذُوهُ عَدُوًّا. Wherein the shaitan is your enemy. Not people. They are not your enemies. Shaitan is your enemy. فَاتَّخِذُوهُ عَدُوًّا. Take him as your enemy. Then after that, after learning this, no one is my enemy. And I'm not enemy to anyone else. I don't carry grudges or malicious heart or hatred or jealousy or any kind of animosity in my heart. No one is my enemy. Shaitan is my enemy and I'm going to disobey Shaitan. Subhanallah. He says, you know, I increase my love, you know, increase love in my heart for the people, for Allah's creation. I start loving them. He says, that's great. What else? But another thing I have learned. What is it? You know, people, they trust their intellectual. They trust. They rely on their intellectual power. They rely on their position. They rely on their wealth. They rely on their things that belongs to them. And ultimately they think that these are the things will save me. And because of these things, I am more powerful, I am intellectual, I am smart. Because they do tawakkul on them. So he says, when I've learned this, وَمَنْ يَتَوَكَّلَ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَهُوَ حَسْبُهُ. So whoever trusts in Allah, he is enough for him. And I built my trust in Allah. I increased trust in my heart in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Although I'm involved in these things, but I trust in Allah more than anything else. Ultimate trust is in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, after hearing this, all, you know, that he had learned from his shaykh, from his teacher, he called him, Hatim, you are saying that you have learned only 8 things? Because Shaykh Shafiq Balkhi, he studied Torah, Zabur, Injil, of course Quran, and he had a deep knowledge. And so, you know, I checked Torah, Zabur, Injil and Quran. The ultimate understanding and ultimate teaching of all 4 books are within these 8 things. These are the extract and conclusion of all these revelations. My brothers and sisters, when I studied this conversation, you know, between student and teacher, it touched my heart. And right now, disturbance, you know, in Muslim Ummah, whether individual or collectively, that we have, to reflect or if we implement these things in our life could change. Believe me, our life could change. That's like, you know, right from the beginning. If we stay away from evil desires and evil deeds, of course you will be closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And within 8 things, you could say that you are fulfilling hukukullah and hukukul ibad. Just only hukukullah and hukukul ibad. If you fulfill hukukullah, the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and at the same time hukukul ibad, the rights of His creation, what else is left? These are the major things. And sometimes, you know, we ignore. We don't pay attention. And just one or two things is not enough in our life. Islam is a way of life. In the deen inda Allah in Islam. Islam is a way of life. It's not only few things. For each and every single step that we take, if we think, if we take it, that this step makes me closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or this step does not take away someone's rights, we have to be thankful. If we have any lacking in the shortcomings, think about how can we rectify ourselves. And finally, inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless us all. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المؤمنين والمؤمنات إنه الغفور. الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا وسندنا ومولانا محمد عبده ورسوله حبيبه وخليله أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا ومولانا محمد بعدد من صلى وصام اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد بعدد من قاد وقام وصل على جميع الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى كل ملائكتك المقربين وعلى عباد الله الصالحين ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم اللهم أيد الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم انصر المسلمين في كل مكان اللهم انصر المسلمين في كل مكان اللهم انصر من نصر دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وجعلنا منهم اللهم اخذل من خذل دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا تجعلنا منهم اللهم ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار عباد الله رحمكم الله إن الله يأمركم بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله يذكركم وله يستجيب لكم ولذكر الله تعالى على مولاه عز وجل وتم وهم وادم واكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون اقيم الصلاه
الله اكبر الله اكبر الله اكبر الله اكبر اشهد ان لا اله الا الله اشهد ان لا اله الا الله اشهد ان محمدا رسول الله اشهد ان محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
لا إله إلا الله صفوفكم رحمكم الله تعالى sit in your rows fill up the gaps please check your cell phones جزاك الله خير الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. تبارك الذي جعل في السماء بروجا وجعل فيها سراجا وقمرا منيرا وهو الذي جعل الليل والنهار خلفة لمن أراد أن يذكر أو أراد شكورا وعباد الرحمن الذين يمشون على الأرض هونا وإذا خاطبهم الجاهلون قالوا سلاما والذين يبيتون لربهم سجدا وقياما. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. أرأيت الذي يكذب بالدين فذلك الذي يدع اليتيم ولا يحض على طعام المسكين فويل للمصلين الذين هم عن صلاتهم ساهون الذين هم يراءون ويمنعون الماعون. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. نظف الحمد.